Hello and welcome to Business Analytics. This is Hari Rajagopalan and I will be your instructor for this lecture today. So you have already gone through indescriptive analytics and kind of part of predictive analytics, hypothesis testing. And then after hypothesis testing, we looked at how we are going to calculate beta. Now in this example, we are going to focus on how we are going to calculate the sample size we need for a hypothesis test. Let's take the same example we have been using about a quality control manager who needs to decide a shipment of batteries from a supplier or whether they should return the shipment because of poor quality. And you know that the average useful life of a battery should be at least 120 hours and a standard deviation, which is the population standard deviation, is 12 hours. And to evaluate the quality of incoming shipment, a sample of 36 batteries will be selected and tested. And really, the quality control manager must decide whether to accept the shipment or to return the supplied batteries because of poor quality. So in this problem, our hypothesis to say average battery life is less than 120 hours, in which case we reject it and we send it. If the hypothesis or alternate hypothesis is true, we send it back. If the null hypothesis, which says that it's not less than 120 hours, average battery life, then we keep the shipment. So let's take a quick look at what we're looking at here. So here is the sampling distribution of sample means when null hypothesis is true, and population mean is of where the sample is coming from is equal to null hypothesis. So here we're looking at, here is null hypothesis and the population mean. Here is the mean distribution of sample means. So x-axis is sample means. And so we are looking at, it's a lower tail test, so alpha is 5%. And you know from the past we have calculated this. It's 116.71 is the critical hours, is the critical value. So anything less, if you get a sample mean which is less than 116.71, you reject your null hypothesis and essentially send the batteries back. If it's more, you fail to reject. Now here is where you have the alternate distribution. So here we are assuming, let's assume that the population mean in an alternate distribution is 112. So here we are assuming that the sample comes from a population where the average is less than null hypothesis distribution. So this distribution assumes that null hypothesis is false. So the same 116.71, now you can calculate your beta, and beta is 9.1% or 0.091%, right? And you did this in your last lecture. So how do we find the sample size using this? So first you find the z-score for alpha. You basically use norm.s.inv. You find the z-score for beta. And then the critical value, as we looked at, the critical value is at the same spot for alpha and beta, right? So we can essentially use that. So the formula for critical value from alpha is this formula, right? You're going to use minus the z-score times standard error. And from the alternate hypothesis distribution is this formula, and they're both equal because it gives the same value. And the standard error is given by this formula. So if you plug in both these equations, and you don't have to resolve them, I've already given you the equation, the sample size will be equal to z-score for alpha plus z-score for beta multiplied by population standard deviation, not the standard error, but the population standard deviation, divided by the difference between the null hypothesis mean and the alternate hypothesis mean. And then you take the whole square of this. Now, because you're squaring this, don't worry if your z-score is negative or positive. You're just going to add them here for the same spot. You're going to take the value and add them together. So let's take the same example. So we here is the example, right? And we have talked about up to the hypothesis and null hypothesis. We've talked about it. So type one error is if the mean battery life in the shipment is 120 hours, then the as a manager, you're willing to, and this is the population mean, you're willing to risk a 5% alpha, 5% probability of rejecting the shipment. Now let's say that the manager also says that if the mean battery life in the shipment is 5 hours under specification, that is 115, I'm willing to risk a beta, a type 2 error of 10% probability of accepting the shipment, that I would accept the shipment at a beta of 10%. Now, where did I get this 115? This is just a number based on judgment of the manager. Someone else might specify a different restriction on the probabilities, right? However, statements about allowable probabilities for both errors must be made before the sample size can be determined, okay? So now that we're doing this, we have in this problem, null hypothesis is 120. Your alternate hypothesis mean is 115. Population standard deviation is 12. That's given, right? We find the z-score for alpha 5% by using norm.s.inv, and we get negative 1.645. Beta for 10%, we plug in beta, we get negative 1.28. And then we put them together, solve them for sample size using that equation. So 1.64 here, 1.28 here. We don't have to worry, since both of them are negative, we can just add them together. And since we are squaring them, you don't have to worry about the sign. You multiply it by the sample, population standard deviation. And then you subtract these two. The difference between the two hypothesis means of 5. And so we get about 49.3, which means a sample size of 50. So we can look at changing this by changing the beta and the alternate hypothesis mean different values, and you can look at what your sample size should be. The difference between your null hypothesis mean and alternate hypothesis mean is really your effect size. How big is the difference? The larger this difference is, difference between the two, the less a sample size you need. So let's say you have a very, very large difference, you need a very small sample to show the difference.